Here he comes, here comes Speed Racer. He's a demon on wheels. He's a demon and he's gonna be chasing after someone. He's gaining on you, so you better look alive. He's busy revving up the powerful Mach 5. And when the odds are against him and there's dangerous work to do, you bet your life, Speed Racer, you'll see it through. Go, Speed Racer, go, Speed Racer, go, Speed Racer, go. He's up and flying as he guns a car around the track. He's jamming down the pedal like he's never coming back. Adventure's waiting just ahead. Go, Speed Racer, go, Speed Racer, go, Speed Racer, go.
Ever since early men began to compete against each other in games or sports, there have been rewards to the winners. And for thousands of years, perhaps that was enough. But as man became more civilized, other rewards were given in various forms, the most universal being a trophy. This is the reward for the winner of the Around the World Grand Prix, a small mountain of the purest gold, donated by Mr. Carrot Goldminter.
The Around the World Grand Prix will start in California. The race will begin in Los Angeles, cross the United States to Miami, then head south, cross the Amazon, then traverse South America to the Andes, and go through Chile all the way south past Cape Horn. Then eastward and up through the heart of Africa to the Mediterranean. Then northward through Europe to the British Isles. Eastward again all the way across Russia and Siberia, and finally to finish in Tokyo, Japan.
From the start to the finish line is 25,000 miles. It's amazing what man will do for gold, but there will be one more prize for the winner.
Another?
The winner of the race will also get my daughter Lovelace as a bride.
What? That's very generous, sir.
You know as well as I do, that's the best prize of all.
Miss Goldminter, your father said you'd marry the winner of the Grand Prix. He's going to give you away as a bride. Tell us how you feel about that.
I'm sorry, but I don't wish to make any public comment about it at this time. I'm going to Paris. Come along, Oscar.
Yes, sir.
Ridiculous! Daddy has no right to make such a promise. Now I better get ready. I'll marry whom I please. After all, I may not want to marry the winner of the race.
I don't blame you, Lovelace. I've seen some of those professional races, and they're not refined enough for you, my dear child.
Who knows what kind of dangers they'll run into in a race around the world? Anything can happen. I'm afraid it's going to be much too dangerous, and I'm worried about Speed being in it.
But the prize is enough gold to make him rich, and nobody can turn down an opportunity like that.
But, Pop, suppose something happens to him. What good's all the money in the world if he couldn't enjoy it?
But Speed's a professional racer, and every top professional racer in the world is going to compete. He's got to race against them. If Speed backed out of the Around the World Grand Prix, everyone would laugh at him and figure he's just plain scared. So that's final. Speed's got to take part in the race. Let's just hope that he ends up the winner. Don't worry now. Speed's a big boy who can take care of himself.
We wish you all the luck in the world, Speed. Please be careful and come home to us safely. Please.
This is Jim Pearltone of the Special Broadcasting Network speaking to you from Los Angeles, where the fantastic Around the World Grand Prix, the greatest race in history, will begin.
Well, it won't be long now. I've checked the rules very carefully.
And what did you come up with, Scrounge?
Something very interesting. So where in the rules is there a rule saying it's forbidden to interfere with the other drivers? Nowhere.
Interesting.
Also, it won't matter how the winner wins, so long as he wins. Some drivers might try to be dishonest, it seems to me. It's not fair that someone might cheat to win it.
They might win, but they'd lose, too. They'd lose their honor.
Their honor?
Sure. Who could be proud of winning if he cheated to win? It's not worth it. All the gold in the world isn't worth a man's honor. That's the most precious thing there is.
Out of what stupid book did you get that stupid idea? Little Mr. Goody over there thinks he's smart with ideas like that. Ah, there's a joker for a joker.
Thanks, but I don't play your game.
I'm warning you. Don't try to be smart.
I think he needs more than a warning. Give him what he needs, Sage.
That'll be a pleasure. Aren't you talking about honor because you're too scared to do everything you can to win?
I'll win fair and square, and no other way.
Yeah, well, that's not the way I'm going to beat you up.
Just remember, you started it.
And I'm going to finish it.
All right, that's enough. You win the fight.
It's too bad, but he asked for it.
Okay, you stonehead, get up.
Why don't you save your fighting for when you're in the race? After all, isn't that what racing and other sports are all about? Aren't they all just more sophisticated ways of fighting? Save yourselves for the race.
I'd rather see them knock themselves out now. It'll leave less competition for me. I'll have a better chance to win.
That's a strange way to talk. What kind of a racer are you?
That's what I was wondering. If a racer cheats to win, what kind of bridegroom is he going to make for that rich girl, Lovelace Goldminter?
Well, she's probably no bargain either.
What makes you say that?
I just figure that her father is so rich, he probably spoiled her. I'm willing to bet she's just a spoiled brat.
You think she could be a brat?
Yes, I'll bet she's had everything handed to her on a gold platter since she was born. I've met that type before, and they're poison. I'm staying away from a girl like that.
Young lady?
Oscar, that race for my hand is ridiculous, and I'm going to interfere with it as much as I can.
Two more minutes before the fantastic Around the World Grand Prix will start. They're off! The pitman and mechanic of each team will follow their driver in a helicopter.
Careful, Speed. I've heard that some people have been hired to use every trick they can to knock cars out of the race.
Miami in only 13 hours.
Now's the time to begin the oil operation.
Oil?
To disrupt the whole race, and that's the only reason I'm in it, to teach my father he can't force me to marry anyone.
I've got to be careful of car number four. They're planning to make trouble. Let's get to work.
That's gonna slow them down.
Catch up.
cars have crossed the United States. And after passing through Washington, D.C., they race southward toward Florida.
Which boat is Pete getting on, Jim? Jim, do you know?
To maintain the lead, Sparky, keep a sharp eye out for trouble.
The engine's running perfectly, and they predict clear weather for 20 more hours. Everything's okay.
Number five should have trouble any minute. Number five speedboat. I wonder what she means by that.
Huh? Oh, fire! That speed!
If it reaches the floor, we'll blow up. We've got to get it out.
Oh, it looks as if Speed's boat's burning up.
Hmm? Yeah, and a boat of you can on board, huh?
How did you know that number five would have trouble? You must have planned it.
Well, the fire's out.
Hiya, Speedy.
Huh? Spritel, what are you doing out here in the middle of the ocean?
Oh, just paddling around.
That's a likely story.
The driver of boat number one planned the fire.
Hmm? What a dirty trick. Come on, let's repair the damage.
Okay.
According to this map, we've covered 1,500 miles of water. We're making good time. The radar shows rocks ahead.
I'll be careful.
Two racers have been shipwrecked.
Let's run them down.
We're in terrible danger. These waters are full of sharks.
what's the matter? Why are we coming to a stop?
It's just my idea of fair play.
Do you really mean you're going to help them?
We'll lose first place. And besides, Spritel said they're the ones who planned the fire.
I know, but we can't abandon them to the sharks, Sparky. Hop on board and I'll take you to that island where you'll be safe.
Thanks, but no thanks. We don't want any favors.
Don't forget the sharks.
You'd better not be so stubborn and accept our help.
Don't worry about us. We're able to swim to the island.
Well, I'm not sure about that.
Sharks are going to be distracted for a while.
What do we do?
Now's your chance to get away. You have a few minutes while they're having supper.
And I don't even belong to that generation.
It's about time you got here.
Well, it takes time to steal a boat.
Pay the number one on it and hurry. We've got to knock number five out of the race.
We will when we catch him.
The mightiest river in the world, the Amazon.
Spritel and Chim Chim stowed aboard again.
Pops, will you take care of them? We've got to hurry.
Sure.
Come on, Sparky.
Wait for us, Speed. Hey, put us down, Pops. We've got to be in the race with Speed. He needs us.
Looks as if number five and number one are out of the race.
And with them out of the way, it'll be a breeze for us to win. Come on, step on it.
An alligator.
I had a feeling winning wouldn't be easy.
Look!
Well, you know, that was boat number one.
Huh?
Those alligators are going to keep them busy.
That'll keep them out of the race.
Oscar, get to work.
Yes, ma'am.
Hang on!
If I don't get us out of this, we'll never win. So hang on, Sparky.
Thank you.
try to get over the storm. Sparky, while I try to put an end to that.
He's asking for it. We'll give it to him.
Right.
Sparky escaped? Don't miss the next exciting episode of Speed Racer.
Said you'd marry the winner of the Grand Prix. He's going to give you away as a bride. Then tell us how you feel about that.
I'm sorry, but I don't wish to make any public comment about it at this time. I'm going to Paris. Come along, Oscar.
Yes, sir.
Ridiculous! Daddy has no right to make such a promise. Now I better get ready. I'll marry whom I please. After all, I may not want to marry the winner of the race.
I don't blame you, Lovelace. I've seen some of those professional races, and they're not refined enough for you, my dear child.
Who knows what kind of dangers they'll run into in a race around the world? Anything can happen. I'm afraid it's going to be much too dangerous, and I'm worried about Speed being in it.
But the prize is enough gold to make him rich, and nobody can turn down an opportunity like that.
But, Pop, suppose something happens to him. What good's all the money in the world if he couldn't enjoy it?
But Speed's a professional racer, and every top professional racer in the world's going to compete. He's got to race against them. If Speed backed out of the Around the World Grand Prix, everyone would laugh at him and figure he's just plain scared. So that's final. Speed's got to take part in the race. Let's just hope that he ends up the winner. Don't worry now. Speed's a big boy who can take care of himself.
We wish you all the luck in the world, Speed. Please be careful and come home to us safely. Please.
This is Jim Pearltoad of the Special Broadcasting Network speaking to you from Los Angeles, where the fantastic Around the World Grand Prix, the greatest race in history, will begin.
Well, it won't be long now. I've checked the rules very carefully.
And what did you come up with, Scrounge?
Something very interesting. So where in the rules is there a rule saying it's forbidden to interfere with the other drivers? Nowhere.
Interesting.
Also, it won't matter how they win or win, so long as he wins. Some drivers might try to be dishonest, it seems to me. It's not fair that someone might cheat to win it.
They might win, but they'd lose, too. They'd lose their honor.
Their honor?
Sure. Who could be proud of winning if he cheated to win? It's not worth it. All the gold in the world isn't worth a man's honor. That's the most precious thing there is.
Hmm. Out of what stupid book did you get that stupid idea? Little Mr. Goody over there thinks he's smart with ideas like that. Ah, there's a joker for a joker.
Thanks, but I don't play your game.
I'm warning you. Don't try to be smart.
I think he needs more than a warning. Give him what he needs, Shade.
That'll be a pleasure. Aren't you talking about honor because you're too scared to do everything you can to win?
I'll win fair and square and no other way.
Yeah, well, that's not the way I'm going to beat you up.
Just remember, you started it.
And I'm going to finish it.
Or enough gold to make him rich, and nobody can turn down an opportunity like that.
But, Pop, suppose something happens to him. What good's all the money in the world if he couldn't enjoy it?
But Speed's a professional racer, and every top professional racer in the world's going to compete. He's got to race against them. If Speed backed out of the Around the World Grand Prix, everyone would laugh at him and figure he's just plain scared. So that's final. Speed's got to take part in the race. Let's just hope that he ends up the winner. Don't worry now. Speed's a big boy who can take care of himself.
We wish you all the luck in the world, Speed. Please be careful and come home to us safely. Please.
This is Jim Pearltoad of the Special Broadcasting Network speaking to you from Los Angeles, where the fantastic Around the World Grand Prix, the greatest race in history, will begin.
Well, it won't be long now. I've checked the rules very carefully.
And what did you come up with, Scrounge?
Something very interesting. So where in the rules is there a rule saying it's forbidden to interfere with the other drivers? Nowhere.
Interesting.
Also, it won't matter how they win or win, so long as he wins. Some drivers might try to be dishonest, it seems to me. It's not fair that someone might cheat to win it.
They might win, but they'd lose, too. They'd lose their honor.
Their honor?
Sure. Who could be proud of winning if he cheated to win? It's not worth it. All the gold in the world isn't worth a man's honor. That's the most precious thing there is.
Out of what stupid book did you get that stupid idea? Little Mr. Goody over there thinks he's smart with ideas like that. Ah, there's a joker for a joker.
Thanks, but I don't play your game.
I'm warning you. Don't try to be smart.
I think he needs more than a warning. Give him what he needs, Shade.
That'll be a pleasure. Aren't you talking about honor because you're too scared to do everything you can to win?
I'll win fair and square and no other way.
Yeah, well, that's not the way I'm going to beat you up.
Just remember, you started it.
And I'm going to finish it.
All right, that's enough. You win the fight.
It's too bad, but he asked for it.
Okay, you stonehead, get up.
What does it say you're fighting for when you're in the race? After all, isn't that what racing and other sports are all about? Aren't they all just more sophisticated ways of fighting? Save yourselves for the race.
I'd rather see them knock themselves out now. It'll leave less competition for me. I'll have a better chance to win.
That's a strange way to talk. What kind of a racer are you?
That's what I was wondering. If a racer cheats to win, what kind of bridegroom is he going to make for that rich girl, Lovelace Goldminter?
Well, she's probably no bargain either.
What makes you say that?
I just figured that her father is so rich, he probably spoiled her. I'm willing to bet she's just a spoiled brat.
You think she could be a brat?
Yes, I'll bet she... I'll try to get over the storm.
Another.
causing trouble again.
Well, hang on, Sparky, while I try to put an end to that.
He's asking for it. We'll give it to him.
Right.
Sparky escaped? Don't miss the next exciting episode of Speed Racer.
Which boat is Speed getting on, Chim Chim? Do you know?
Try to maintain the lead, Sparky. Keep a sharp eye out for trouble.
The engine's running perfectly, and they predict clear weather for 20 more hours. Everything's okay.
Number 5 should have trouble any minute.
Number 5 speedboat. I wonder what she means by that.
Huh? Oh, fire! That speed!
If it reaches the fuel, we'll blow up. We've got to get it out.
Oh, it looks as if Speed's boat's burning up.
Yeah, how did both of you get on board, huh?
How did you know that number 5 would have trouble? You must have planned it.
Let's go. We'll head for the mainland. Come on, faster.
Oh, I'm beat, and I don't even belong to that generation.
It's about time you got here.
Well, it takes time to steal a boat.
Pay the number one on it and hurry. We've got to knock number five out of the race.
We will when we catch him.
The mightiest river in the world, the Amazon.
Don't tell me Spraddle and Chim Chim stowed aboard again.
Pops, will you take care of them? We've got to hurry.
Sure.
Come on, Sparky.
Wait for us, Speed. Hey, put us down, Pops. We've got to be in the race with Speed. He needs us.
Looks as if number five and number one are out of the race.
And with them out of the way, it'll be a breeze for us to win. Come on, step on it.
An alligator.
I had a feeling winning wouldn't be easy.
Look!
What do you know? That was boat number one.
Huh?
Those alligators are going to keep them busy.
That'll keep them out of the race.
Oscar, get to work.
Yes, ma'am. Hang on!
If I don't get us out of this, we'll never win. So hang on, Sparky.
Child.
Who knows what kind of dangers they'll run into in a race around the world? Anything can happen. I'm afraid it's going to be much too dangerous, and I'm worried about Speed being in it.
But the prize is enough gold to make him rich, and nobody can turn down an opportunity like that.
But, Pop, suppose something happens to him. What good's all the money in the world if he couldn't enjoy it?
But Speed's a professional racer, and every top professional racer in the world is going to compete. He's got to race against them. If Speed backed out of the Around the World Grand Prix, everyone would laugh at him and figure he's just plain scared. So that's final. Speed's got to take part in the race. Let's just hope that he ends up the winner. Don't worry now. Speed's a big boy who can take care of himself.
We wish you all the luck in the world, Speed. Please be careful and come home to us safely. Please.
This is Jim Pearltoad of the Special Broadcasting Network speaking to you from Los Angeles, where the fantastic Around the World Grand Prix, the greatest race in history, will begin.
Well, it won't be long now. I've checked the rules very carefully.
And what did you come up with, Scrounge?
Something very interesting. So where in the rules is there a rule saying it's forbidden to interfere with the other drivers? Nowhere.
Interesting.
Also, it won't matter how they win or win, so long as he wins. Some drivers might try to be dishonest, it seems to me. It's not fair that someone might cheat to win it.
They might win, but they'd lose, too. They'd lose their honor.
Their honor?
Sure. Who could be proud of winning if he cheated to win? It's not worth it. All the gold in the world isn't worth a man's honor. That's the most precious thing there is.
Out of what stupid book did you get that stupid idea? Little Mr. Goody over there thinks he's smart with ideas like that. There's a joker for a joker.
Thanks. But I don't play your game.
I'm warning you. Don't try to be smart.
I think he needs more than a warning. Give him what he needs, Sage.
That'll be a pleasure. Aren't you talking about honor because you're too scared to do everything you can to win?
I'll win fair and square in no other way.
Yeah. Well, that's not the way I'm going to beat you up.
Just remember, you started it.
And I'm going to finish it.
All right, that's enough. You win the fight.
It's too bad, but he asked for it.
Okay, you stonehead, get up.
What does it say you're fighting for when you're in the race? After all, isn't that what racing and other sports are all about? Aren't they all just more sophisticated ways of fighting? Save yourselves for the race.
I'd rather see them knock themselves out now. It'll leave less competition for me. I'll have a better chance to win.
That's a strange way to talk. What kind of a racer are you?
That's what I was wondering. If a racer cheats to win, what kind of bridegroom is he going to make for that rich girl, Lovelace Goldminter?
Well, she's probably no bargain either.